feel like I was just on another planet. Wonder if this is what it's like to be Buster.
When do they stop tuning their instruments and play the music?
That is the music.
What on earth was that?
Why are you crying?
This is the most beautiful piece of art I ever heard in my life.
The music in a game can really make or break the overall experience and enjoyment for a player. To create a timeless gaming masterpiece, you'll inevitably have to make a timeless gaming masterpiece soundtrack. And I don't think people talk about that enough. Literally, gaming soundtracks is the biggest pillar I consider when I want to see if I enjoy a game or not. There is no good times playing a game without a solid soundtrack being played in the background. Keep in mind, these game soundtracks are on loop. So yeah, it might be good on the first try, it might be cool on the second try. But hey, 76 tries later, is it still banging? Is it still bearable? Do you want to shoot yourself? From the title screen all the way to the credits, if the tunes ain't slapping, I'm throwing that shit away.
Don't let a single one get away!
There are three main attributes to look into when creating an overall theme for a game. The world design, the mechanics, and the music.
I'm here to argue.
Before the playstyle, before the characters, the power systems, the world settings, the antagonists, blah, 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 the music sets the tone for the whole game. The whole video game.
You know, more often than not, the title screen introduction soundtrack, along with good visuals, of course, is like a teaser trailer for what's to come into that game.
If it ain't good, why the fuck would I continue playing? The music's like an anime opening. If they don't have the budget to show a solid 1 minute and 30 seconds of an absolute banger, then I can't lie, they probably didn't have the money to make a good anime in the first place. Oh, you don't believe me? Oh, ye of little faith. All right, let me explain this in terms your monkey brain can understand, okay? Think of the music in the game as its own character, an integral part of your team or party. Without such a dependable teammate, your gaming experience is just gonna be ass, I can't lie. You know, it's an assist type, it can't do much by itself, but the buffs against the rest of the party, oh wee bomb. Listen, yeah, I've seen games go from ass crack dust to pretty decent. Because of the soundtrack.
The death egg? Oh man, that's not good. None of this is good, Vector. That's why it's called war.
Look, and I get it, you still might not get what I'm saying. Not everybody has been blessed by the heavens like the way I have. So I'm gonna show you how you know the game you're playing has a sick soundtrack.
Oh, this is good right here. I like this.
If the visuals of the game is one side of the coin, the audios and the soundtracks that complement the visuals are the other side. Both are needed to tell a very good fucking story. Yes, nigga, story. Sorry to blow your teeny 2K FIFA called Neutron Brain, but most timeless games that will always be remembered as GOATs, they're games that tell a good, strong, compelling story. That you need the music to do that. Games like Undertale, Persona, or literally any Mario or Sonic game that gives out consistent classics that not only sound great to listen to on loop, they all have music and soundtracks that complement the story, but they also tell the story on a deeper level than just words or graphics. There's a reason why numerous YouTubers use these gaming soundtracks in their videos, people, because they know that I know that they're sadistic fucks, and they want you to relive repressed memories. I didn't mean to. I didn't want the killer. I didn't know.
Six Pokemon and their stupid fucking idiot trainer march into the Indigo Plateau as this was our first and final chance to come out as champions, as this Pokemon Nuzlocke was about to end one way or another.
There is a narrative and a plot being told through the precise choice of the flow and the playstyle of the music. A lighter high-pitched sound from a violin tells a story of a more cunning, smaller boss or situation. Maybe you gotta sneak into some place without getting caught, but the ops are about to catch you and you are like within range of one accidental push of your analog controller, and you gotta start from the beginning, and then you might be like, you know what, fuck this, I'm not doing this anymore, because bro, I actually spent like 20 minutes to get into this place and there was no safe out throughout this whole thing, while heavy, loud drums of a
dirty bassline tells the story of a larger, upfront and personal kind of boss. Fuck stealth, nigga. I'm about to go Shadow of Colossus on this nigga, and your neighbor's neighbor is about to hear me knock him the fuck out. Trumpets tell a narrative of imperialism, medieval triumph and victory, and an army of a single being leading thousands of people. Well, all the above play with electronic filters give a cyberpunk urban city life kind of feel to it, you know? Also, then there's this.
I'm not gonna fucking take it!
It's like building a bear with unlimited customizable parts, each given their own story and vibe. Look at Breath of the Wild. Nigga, there's no way you'd believe Link is alone in a land he doesn't know or recognize at all if he constantly had some blaring trumpets and like, "Ooh, guys, I'm over here." Instead, the music is quiet. Sometimes even silent. See, even the lack of music is music. Oh my god. You know, you still don't get it? Well, we're slow in our own aspects. It's okay. I'm gonna play a song, and I challenge you just to close your eyes, okay? Just close your eyes and imagine the scenery, the characters, and the overall vibe. Alright? Ready? Go. See what I mean? See why my top artists on Spotify are Sega Sound Team and Toby Fox? Nigga, I'm about to be my maker already. I'm levitating. It's over. See you guys later. A game that can utilize the soundtrack to complement the story is a game that's rich in originality and uniqueness. A true classic that will be remembered. Super Mario Galaxy literally had a soundtrack for every single galaxy with multiple versions depending on your environment. This matters, okay? Spend money on this because the dopamine of going from the surface level to underwater and the music changing, is immaculate. It is immaculate. These details matter, okay? Music matters. The music is one of the major factors of immersing yourself into a universe to unplug you from whatever shitty setup you have and make you feel like you're really fighting a 20-foot lizard demon, an undead skeleton, or whatever fan our second decides to steal as the villain for the new game. The design of the world and the gaming mechanics are important when creating an overall energy to a game. Don't get me wrong, okay? But if those things listed are cheese and bread, a good fucking soundtrack is akin to the infinite amount of toppings you can have in a pizza. Infinite! They're powerful and rich in passion. And the right one can completely transform your gaming experience. Ba 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 ba